Hello everybody and welcome to my weekly video. I'm Rainbow Red Panda and this is Norton and this is Mochi, our foster kitty, and I just got back from the comic book store. I went to two comic book stores today. Part of my story time, I guess. This is almost a comic time. This is almost like old times with comics, because I have new comics and I went to two different comic book stores. I walked around a lot today around the city and I didn't even need my GPS because apparently I'm just learning things. Mochi is all wet. I'm not really sure what she's been into, but whatever. So I went to Forbidden Planet, which I have never been in a Forbidden Planet before. This was my first time. I see people on the YCC and different sites post about going to Forbidden Planet or ordering from Forbidden Planet all the time. Well, I don't live in the UK where there are Forbidden Planets, so there's, I think, one or two in New York. Other than that, they're like all overseas from what I understand. So I had never been to one. I was just sort of walking on my way to the other comic store and I came across one, so I was like, hey, I'm gonna go in here. And I didn't end up buying anything. I wanted to buy everything, but I didn't end up buying anything. But it was a really awesome experience. They're actually doing some construction on that one, so instead of the two stories that it usually is, it was just one. So they had like two stories worth of stuff all compiled into one. But they had some awesome t-shirts that I want to go back and get. They have an awesome comic selection, and unlike the other comic store that I went to, all of their back issues of comics are cover price still, so that's good. But I don't know, I really, really liked it. It's sort of out of my way, unless I do the same path today. Every Wednesday, it would be out of my way to go there every week. But it is cool. They do have some like exclusive stuff that you can't get anywhere else. They had a bunch of stuff, and I'm very glad that I went, and I look forward to future visits. I still want to go back and get some of the t-shirts that I saw, because they're pretty awesome. Besides that, I don't know, I did a bunch of just random shopping in New York. I only like bought like two things. Most of them are food related. The other store that I went to was the Midtown Comics. Midgard is my comic store in Illinois and I miss them so much. I went to Midtown Comics on 46th Street in Lexington. And I got some comic books. Look, Mochi, this is a comic book. Isn't it pretty? I got these books. So I'm pretty excited about them. I'll go through the old stuff first. The old stuff that I got is, I'm catching up on Chew. So I got Chew number 43. And Chew number 44. And Chew number 45. And then this is Saga. This is number 22, which I may have read this one already. I really don't remember. 22, 23, 24, and then that's it. So I got those. And then the new stuff that I got, Saga 25. Mochi has left my lap. I got Bitch Planet number 2 because I figure I might as well try and follow a series while I still can. I'm so out of date with everything. Return of the Living Deadpool number 1. I talked about this in one of my last videos and I'm so excited to read this. I really want to see Pandapool come back. And okay, I got this one mainly because it was the first issue of something. I'm not sure if it's going to be good or not. I like the writer, so I'm gonna say that I have good expectations of it, but we'll see. Ant-Man number 1. I feel like I've heard some bad things about this already on the internet. I'm not sure. I haven't read it yet. So I'm gonna read Ant-Man number 1. Got Deadpool number 41. So I'm excited about that one. This is one that I got just because it's a number one and it looks interesting. It had two different cover choices and I went with this one. It is Postal number 1. It's an Image comic. It is like one of the first Top Cow comics that I've seen that isn't done by J. Michael Straczynski. But I'm excited for it. I think that it looks interesting, and it's an Image comic, so that makes me think that it's gonna be good because Image just sort of has that reputation these days. And then the last one that I got, I decided to get because the issue number was significant, but also it's a Scotty Young cover. It is Spawn issue number 250, so it's dark. I'm sorry. But this is the Scotty Young Spawn cover. I really like Scotty Young, so anytime I'm able to just pick up one of his covers off the shelf, I'm gonna do it. So pick that. Like, look at that. It's a cake. So yeah. So happy 250, Spawn. So yeah, those are the new comics that I got. There's a lot that I wanted to get. I'm almost glad that I didn't keep buying new comic books every week once I moved to New York. One, because I would be in a lot of debt right now. It's one of the reasons why I haven't been buying them because I can't afford that right now. It's like that's a lot of money. And with all of the new, I think like every time Marvel cancels one series, they have like three spin-offs. So I was looking at the shelves today and I was like, I would probably be up to like 100 comics a week. Almost with all of the Spider-Verse stuff and Original Sins, all of that stuff that's still going on, I would have so many things to catch up on. So, as much as I want to get all of those single issues, all of the Spider-Verse things, tie-in series, all of that, as much as I want to get all of those and I want to finish out Original Sin, I almost hope that they just make like an anthology of all of it together. I know they've done like, at least for Original Sin, they've done trades of like the different stories all together, but I want like one book, like a compendium of Original Sin. That's what I need in my life. So if Marvel, someone from Marvel watches this, that's what I need in my life. So I need one of those for Original Sin and I need one of those for Spider-Verse. So if that could happen, Marvel, that would be fantastic. And that's a lot of the comic book stuff. I will probably try and do another one of these Wednesday comic book updates. The Thor annual comes out this month. I don't know if it's next week or the week after, but it comes out and CM Punk's writing it, and the author of Ch or the writer, not the, neither of those things. The illustrator Chu, which is this book, he is doing a variant, and I am really excited about it. It's like a wrestling variant of like Thor and the Hulk, I believe, are the two that are on the cover, and it's gonna be amazing because I don't know. I'm just really, really excited about it, so I can't wait for it to come out. So yeah, that's all the comic book stuff that I have. Side note, if anybody, I don't know if they have these in everywhere where you are, but these are in America and they're supposed to be like the best thing ever. They're in New York around me, so I bought a couple of them. I'm going to make cookies and cream red velvet cupcakes with them. So they are red velvet Oreos. They are delicious. I'm not like obsessed with them. Like I've opened this package and I think I've eaten three. It is a smaller package than regular Oreos, and they're the same price. And I learned that Oreos in New York are expensive, so I feel like I got ripped off a little bit, but for the name of cupcakes, it's okay. So yeah, go get yourself some red velvet Oreos, or just stockpile them and sell them on eBay later because they're already on eBay because people are weird and put everything on eBay. So yeah, red velvet Oreos, comic books. My foster cat, who was on my lap at the beginning of the video, she's not on my lap anymore. But if you're interested in adopting a cat, Mochi is up for adoption and you can adopt her. I don't know what website she's on or anything, but if you like search like New York City cats, I'm sure you'll find her somewhere. So yeah, those are all the things for this week. I was supposed to do a podcast recapping King of the Nerds episodes, and I think that we have officially decided that we're not doing that. I've watched the first two King of the Nerds episodes, And I feel like I dodged a bullet. I was not on that show, and I'm very glad that I was not on that show because the show just seems like a hot mess. It is definitely this season all about the drama, and while there are some, like, the challenges and things are interesting, but I feel like they don't focus a lot on the challenges. It's more on who's gonna make an alliance and who's gonna backstab who. And if I had to be in a house with Todd, I feel like it wouldn't be. I don't think that me and him would get along well together. And it's weird because he's like the comic book guy, so maybe that's why me and him wouldn't get along together. I don't know. But me and him would not get along. I thought that, like, just from watching, like, the videos that I had opinions on people, but after watching two episodes, like, nope, 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 nope. Not doing it. So, if you want to watch King of the Nerds and discuss it with me, I might talk about it periodically on this little weekly video thing that I'm attempting to do, but we'll see. I'm still watching Haven, and it's out there. And there's a lot of, I feel like the writers of the show, they each are told, okay, you have 3 pages to write, and then they just sort of try and take everybody's submissions and, like, mix them together because a lot of stuff doesn't make sense, and then they realize it, and then they try to make it make sense, and it doesn't. But I don't know, I still watch the show, it still entertains me. Edge is on it, and he's entertaining, but even his story has some things that don't make sense. But I'm gonna say that's not his fault. But the whole show is just, I will say that it's based, I'm guessing, very loosely, or at least it was inspired by the Stephen King book, Who Killed the Colorado Kid, or something about the Colorado Kid. And I want to read that book now just to see how closely Haven relates to that book at all. Because I'm guessing that they just said Colorado Kid, and that's the only similarity. But I don't know, because I've never read that particular Stephen King book. So that's all the things. We did watch the Mick Foley documentary, For the Love of Mankind, I believe is what it's called. It's on the WWE Network. It was really good. If you're trying to get people to learn about wrestling, or the reason that me and my boyfriend watched it, I've, known Mankind, Mick Foley, Cactus Jack, Dude Love, whatever name you want to give him, I've known about them since I was born. I've known about him since I was born. And I've watched him through all of his careers and all of his aliases and all of that. And he's sort of, I mean, he's writing a lot. He writes the WWE comic book, which I need to catch up on still. I saw it has some really awesome covers though. Like, there are some pretty awesome covers on that comic. I'm excited. That's one of the things I saw at Forbidden Planet that I think next time I go, I'm gonna, like, buy all of them. But he's been showing up at a lot of conventions, and then we watched the I Am Santa Claus documentary that Netflix had in December, and he's on that because since, like, retiring from professional wrestling, he's sort of doing all the things that he's wanted to do, and so he plays Santa Claus now in the winter, which is really awesome. But he keeps showing up sort of in one way or another in me and my boyfriend's life, and so I was like, hey, like, we need to watch this documentary, like, we need to watch this so that, like, you see, all of Mick Foley, like, okay, he's Santa Claus, he was, like, he knew he was a wrestler, and he knew that he did, like, some hardcore stuff. Like, I think over Christmas we watched the match, the Hell in a Cell match that he had with The Undertaker. That was amazing. But I'm like, you need to watch, like, all of, like, his documentary. You need to get, like, the complete feel of Mick Foley. I can't give you, like, my childhood and my life watching all this stuff live, but I can give you this, which will show you the best and the worst of Mick Foley, Mankind, Cactus Jack, all of them. And it'll show you everything. So he got to see that, and that was cool. And actually, Mick has a stand-up career. I don't know how much he does of it anymore, but he's done shows apparently just right down the block from us. So that's cool. So if he ever does that in the future, I'm totally gonna go. But I don't know how often he actually does that, because he does write a lot, and he does a bunch of stuff with WWE still, and he has conventions and stuff that he goes to all the time and stuff. So I don't know how much he does that, but if you are into wrestling, I highly suggest that documentary, because I think it's really good. I'm debating on having him watch a couple other wrestling documentaries, but I don't know how I feel about it yet, just because some of them I've seen, and like, I'm fine with watching them again, but I feel like I'm subjecting him to them, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to be that girlfriend. Like, if you're not interested, then you're not interested, but like, Mick Foley just kept coming up and stuff, so I figured, you know, this one wouldn't hurt, but now I'm just like, oh, I could show him this one, and this one, and this one, and I have to remind myself, like, that he might not be interested in that, so, yeah, so if you guys have a favorite wrestling documentary, let me know what it is, and if I haven't watched it, maybe I will. I might just have him watch The Wrestler, that movie that came out a few years ago, because I don't think he's seen it, and I liked it. I really, really liked that movie. If you haven't watched The Wrestler, I would suggest it. I thought it was really good. It was the Mickey Rourke movie, and it's sad, though, because apparently it's semi-accurate to how, like, a lot of old professional wrestlers are once they retire, which, that's sad, but I don't know, maybe this movie helped turn it around. I don't know. So, I don't know, go watch The Wrestler, go watch Mick Foley, for the love of mankind or something like that. I believe that the WWE Network is free in February. I think that's what I've read. I don't pay attention since I already have it. It doesn't really affect me one way or another. So, yeah, go check all that out. Read comic books. Watch movies, maybe. I don't know what movies are out. We don't have cable, so I don't watch movie previews that often. And that's all. So I'll see you guys next week. This is a very random video, and I apologize for that. But I'll see you guys next week. So bye!